Right, I forgot about adding that. Okay, now it should work. So it's been a while since the last stream. Well, the good thing was we missed that nobody cares if I show up or not, so they can disappear for a while. Nobody will care. So I guess that's a good thing. But in the meantime, I've been doing some research about this Pinball project, and I did find a program that could help me design an actual table. I did give it a try last week, I think, to make a basic layout like this, and it's thanks to this program, which is, I think, it's made in Visual. That's basically a CAD tool for making layouts for pinballs. So we will build the basics, the walls, and all of that. And I figured I could export it as a PNG and just use it on the engine. And that seems to have actually worked, because it allowed me to do this. Now it does need some extra things so that that doesn't happen, but it is functional. So the first thing we'll do is make a new one, but with the default elements. We will build a table based on that, and then later we can design our own custom layout, hopefully. So first step, having a basic element, it worked. Now we'll make a new one with the default values. So let me create it. And I just save it. So from this we see that it's a huge mess of references, and honestly we don't really need all of these, so we'll just start moving what we don't need like this. But actually this keeps us information about the bumpers. So we do need this, but later. Okay, this rail, I don't think we need it. At least not for this board. These points, no. Those lanes, not either. Not this either. Okay, that we do need. Ah, this is for lights, so no, we can skip this. And the inner parts, we'll keep those. Okay, so we can start working from here and I'll remove some extra elements. So we can say this here. We can delete this. Here's the reference to the spinner. We'll keep that. Ah, here's where we put the gate, so the ball won't go back to the starting area. And this one here has 5 bumpers. These ones will not be necessary, so we can delete them. Another board. I'm not sure if these ones are for the balls or bounce, so I think we can move this safely. That's where the ball spawns. And I think about it, I never made the tower components. I will need to program this later. Okay, so component wise, thanks for the ride, Cuckoo. So I guess you finished Silent Hill 2. If that message is an indication. Yeah, I figured. I never played the game, but I did see people play it, so I was pretty much aware of where the game goes. And just started. The stream will be mostly working with this program to design the pinball table. So maybe there will be some actual programming on this later half. Yeah, I found this a couple of weeks ago, and this will help a lot with the layout for the table. Right before I forget. There we go. So I don't forget later. But yeah, we just barely started, so there won't be any programming yet, maybe in a bit. Once we finish figuring out all the parts that will be going here on this table. So to recap, we have the Clippers here, the slingshots. Provincial will go here. We have the bumpers here. One spinner here. And here on top, the triggers. Okay, so far all of those are elements that we have already programmed. But we still need to make these ones, this type of targets. Okay, we need to remove this because we don't need it. I wonder if this is enough to export it. I guess we don't need this either. Do we need this one here? Since it will be mostly for the flippers, but they will default to the rotation by code, so I guess we can delete this. The crash, good luck. Oh no. Thank you, have a nice rest. And thank you everyone who came along with the raid. There's too much unnecessary stuff here. Maybe this is enough to try to export. We do need those. Not that. Right here. Ah, never mind, this is for the light. We don't need this. Okay, I think we're ready for exporting. Let's see how it looks. So this will just take 1 second. No, there's still too many elements that we don't need here. So that goes away. Maybe if I use a different type of export. No, not this one either. This one will be useful, but only for helping us lay out all the components. Okay, so I guess we can keep this one for later reference, knowing why it's port without all of these elements. So I guess I can create a new layer and move them over there. Let me do that. We don't need those either. This blocks here, we don't need to have our collision. Okay, but I'm sorry, there's no Lord command yet. I always forget to make one. Let me move to that layer. So basically everything that isn't the solid walls, we will have it to export. And these ones we don't need either, so we just delete this since we're here. That should be enough for exporting. This part, the bottom, yeah, maybe. Let's move this too, yeah. That looks good enough now. So I'll just export this. Now the thing with that export is that we cannot use it as it is, we need to do some adjustments. So for now you have to edit it a bit. No, this one was really bad. It did export those things here, so we have to adjust them. We have made this awful curve. I wonder if I can hide that. Much free because in this table here it generated it very neatly. So maybe I can reuse that from the other board. Okay, all the tables get exported with the same dimensions, so we can take advantage of that. So I'll just ignore that for now. First things first. Remove this unnecessary. These circles. I almost forgot that I have some tea. say that. But I just noticed that not all of them are the same dimensions. So now it looks terrible. So maybe I'll try adjusting a little bit. That way they are all the same. In same height. Actually, how do I make sure that they're the same? Yeah, probably quicker just to copy and paste. Where this lower? 3, 4 here. How long have we been making? Casually, I've been doing this for quite a long time. Pretty much since I was a kid, I had some curiosity about how our game is made. So I will try some basic engines here and there, but I think I took it more seriously like 4 or 5 years ago when I started to dedicate more time to making things in Godot. Now I think of even checking that out. Yeah, I'd say that was around time where I finally was able to actually upload games instead of just having some demos here and there on my PC only. Because before that I will always try some new engine, see how it works, and never have anything released or uploaded. It will always be just some testing or following some tutorial. But yeah, I think that was around the time I actually was able to make things on my own and upload them for others to play it. And this is fine. Okay, now I can copy and paste it. Same life. Right, there will be Unity and stuff. Well, I did try using Unity a couple of times, but it was just too cumbersome for me. Because initially I would try to learn to make things in 2D, but back then Unity wasn't ready for that. So I tried to work around the engine to make things into it was too much of a mess. But luckily then Godot show up and I'm going to make things in both 2 and 3D. Yeah, might as well put it to the wall. Okay, now I delete this. Wait, never mind. I have to paint it white. Okay, perfect. Now it's online app. Well, between that and this, you also try pretty much every version of RPG Maker. And I almost had a couple of things uploaded to play, but there was sort of always something that I couldn't make that would stop the project, unfortunately. Okay, next we need to smooth this part here so that the ball doesn't hit that. Yeah, it is useful to learn some of the basics of the push mechanics. Actually, using all of them helped me understand the flow of how to make a battle engine. Because thanks to that, I was able to, let's say, reverse engineer and make my own battle systems for whichever way I wanted. So even though they are limited because they are a framework, not an engine, learning to use them is actually useful in the long run. No. I'm worried this thing isn't smooth enough. It'll probably bump here and make cause a mess, so I wonder if I can make a curve. See if I can pull this off. No. Really, it's nothing special. I'm just going over the whole world because the one I use as default didn't have all of these things that will probably cost the world to hit and go off direction. But yeah, I guess from my point of view, it's not that really impressive. Maybe this is smooth enough. No, it still looks terrible. Okay, that's much better. Yeah, I guess that will do. Actually, what if I maybe that's better. Apparently, doing this by mouth, it's a bit annoying. To go line by line, making sure I don't remove whatever I try drawing. And pulling out the tablet just for this, it's not worth it. Okay, yeah, this is much better. It's not fully a curve, but it will follow along at least. So let's leave that as it is for now. But here we do need to draw the hole. We need to cover the whole section here. I see it's not completely. Much better, maybe just enough. Now we feel it. Yeah, that will do it. This one here, I think. Yeah, maybe I should do the same with the other corner. I see a problem. This one won't go completely straight. So if I fill this, there's this problem here that it won't look completely straight. So but maybe we can. You can ignore that and just leave it be like that. Never mind, now it fits. I use this here too so that the ball doesn't and bump on this area. Maybe if it were a bit more of a curve. Almost. I guess we have to do. I cannot get too much into details, otherwise we'll be staying here a bit longer than we should. So let's leave it at that. Now here's the problem, this part here. We like to be a continuous curve over here. So let's see from where do we start. Maybe here. Maybe that's enough for the curve we want. Let's see. Ah, not bad. No, actually. Okay, I guess this has to be enough. Okay, how that now. And it's here. We have to remove this. And it's two, but we probably won't insert it because we'll reuse the one we made from the other board. This part we painted black. Same here. And I think that's all we need to do with changes. Now you go back to the so let's see here. I have to do one last change. Yes, we still need to resize and remove the part in the middle. Right, so first let's save it like that. Now five things we do is resize it to, let's say, 1008. remove the center parts, and we recolor the walls with white. Thing is, we check only the top parts of the board, which had a height of 905. Right, perfect. And now we export this. So this will take only a second. Okay, now we can start working on the proper table. First I move this new board. Now here it is. So first we replace the top with, where are you? Ah, here. And there we are, almost. And with dinner, thank you for stopping by. Enjoy your dinner. I would like to, but maybe we have to do. Okay, now the thing is, we have to make some new collisions because it's still using the old ones. So move those, and now we can generate new ones for this image. That's gonna be good enough. We can adjust them later. So I'm gonna move all of this to the static body, and there we go. Perfect, that's it all. Now I think we can destroy the table as it is now. And it should work. So let's see. Yeah, it does. But unfortunately, we already found an issue. It just gonna have the edges like that. So unfortunately, it's back to the drawing board. Let me open again the table. Some small triangle here so that it will create an angle at the top. That way they will never get stuck on the top. I guess this will be enough. So 78 by 10. And now what we do is copy and paste to the other ones. This will be problem here with this edge. So in case, I guess we can make a curve here. They never get stuck. Yeah, that should do. And just in case, let's do the same with this three on top. On the bottom, I mean. So let's draw some more triangles here too, but I wonder if the shape should be just as sharp. And funny, but let me draw it downwards. Yeah, this should be good enough. If I should fill in these parts here too. Because something is telling me that the wall will try to get stuck here. Yeah, might as well do that. I don't have any surprises later on. So let's do this, but should we have any kind of curve or not? No, this looks fine enough. We can work with this. And here, it's weird, but coming to the sharp curve, it kind of fits, so I guess we can leave it like that. Now here, ideally I will fill in this whole section, but I think we can use this for another component later on. There's this part of the pinball that will hold the ball for a few moments and then release it quickly again, so I think we can save this section for that component once we have time to create a component first. Okay, now it should be good enough for exporting again. Okay, so we have that saved, and now we'll repeat the whole process. Change the color, we resize it. And we keep the top. This is the top. And we replace it here. Now unfortunately we have to re-import the collisions again. So just to remember, we'll rename this one to bottom collision. So now we can be sure that we can move the rest without worry. And now we create the collisions again. Oh, interesting. I wonder if it will make new ones if are imported as we will see it. Not here. Let's see if this changes anything. No, it doesn't. Oh, interesting. So I guess I have to do even more and readjust myself. So I guess we do the same here. There, and we can new point. When it does these things here, and it generates too many of these points without making the proper shape. Because all it does is give me more work. Unnecessary work. I should move all of this to the bottom. No wonder it was all the way up here. If it doesn't look like the most entertaining part to watch, but this one is really necessary to make sure that the collisions behave as we want to and the ball doesn't go somewhere else, causing a mess. Okay, that should be enough. Adjusting. We have this whole section here, this here, and this frame. Okay. Now let's try the board again. Okay, it's not going as high as it should. Okay. I'm worried that it's not going to do those lines at its own. Maybe they aren't wide enough for people. I can't believe that actually happened. We got the ball actually stuck here. Oh man. Well, it was bound to happen eventually. At least we got it on stream. Now about this ball. So it has a diameter of 20. And what's the length here? Yeah, it should have plenty of space. Maybe I should make the collisions smaller. Yeah, probably just a couple of pixels. Pixels smaller would be enough. Wait, now I'm obsessed to check if it's the same height. Why does it keep looking like it's not that I knew it? The 103. There were weird things that they don't really look like they are the same height, but they actually are, which is the weird part. That's messing with my brain. But whatever, it's online app. And we can test if people will actually pass through. If I can make it hit that area. Because what I'm doing right now is losing. Maybe this area should be a bit thinner, so there's more space for the ball to pass through. Which means it's back to editing the board again. How much material do we remove? Maybe 10 pixels on each side? Thank you. Yeah, let's try cutting the pipe. Pipe pizzas. Right, that should give us plenty more space to work around. Okay, so the purchase was resizing the image. No, it must be the other way around. First, remove the background, and we're repainting this. And then we'll resize it. And we keep the top. I guess I will try and fix this now since we are at it. Okay, and now it's ported as the new top. So now here we replace it with this one. Did it change already? Wait. I have to move it. There we go. Now luckily all we have to do is readjust these collisions here. Okay, hopefully that will give us more space to have the ball go through the lanes. Okay, let's see how it goes. Almost. They don't want to enter. Damn it. I need to remember to shoot it not as hard. There we go. Okay, so now we know for sure that we can go through. Maybe with the bumpers. When we add them here, then we force the ball when it go up. Okay, so I think we can want to add in the other components. But first I'd like to take a small break, so I'll see you in a couple of minutes. the rack. Now we have the basics of the table, but we still need to fill it with some components in the inside. So basically, on top here we have some targets. Here we have a spinner. Right here in the middle we have some bumpers. And right here in the corners we have some slingshots. But first we will need to add some blocks to limit the movement. For example, here at the top we need something that will block the ball only from the outside. So I think for that I had to use this. So I drew something like this. Could it be this? No. I guess this will have to do. Okay, so we have that, and we love it. Let's see where do we have it. I think it has to be a new static body that has one direction. So we call it gate. Ah, never mind. It had to be the collision shape. So this one is the gate. I wonder if it's this way that the collision goes through. I honestly already forgot. Pretty much perfect. That should work for what we need. Now we have to figure out if it was that or the other way around. Well, it was like that. So now if we manage to make it go back, we'll try to and great it happened again. I really need to make these separations. Okay, now will it let me generate the collision from this or not? No, I guess not. That. I mean, I shouldn't have deleted that polygon, but I guess this will work for now to stop people from going here. And actually we could reuse this for these sections, at least for now. That should be enough. So now I give you one more try. Oh, that one semi went through. Great. That's funny how now he actually wants to go through. That works now. Good. Okay, so where do I start? Alright, I want to try some new placeholder assets. So they don't look all with the same color, so. Yeah, I think it was these four. Right, so first we will replace the wall with this one. And we scale it down just a bit. Then the vtuber here, we replace the sprite with this one, just to see how it works. Not so big. Should I fit the collision shape, or should I change that to fit the sprites in particular? Because it almost fits. Now maybe I should reshape the shape so it fits the sprite. Now while we are here, let's solve this issue here. Okay, that's much, much better. Now, where was I? Right, the flippers. I want to try with this new sprite. So first we want to center it. Okay, hopefully now it's back. That was weird. I thought for sure the connection issues will be gone. Right, so as I was saying, now I have to work around this. Actually, I have to replace this space with a new vegetal. And it was on this one. Right here. Now the problem is that we have to resize it to fit the sprite here. Which I guess it won't be as accurate. We should make a scaled down version on the editor. Okay, so I guess we'll start with the vipers here. First I need to resize it. It's good enough. So the stress angle will be 27 and the peak minus 23. Okay, so we can leave this with the default rotation, but we need to adjust the collision shape here. I guess we can work with this. It's accurate enough now. And now we need to fix this one here. So 0.22. Okay, I think that now they are similar enough. Okay, all that's left is setting the new androids. Which I guess will be the opposite of the left one. So I guess it's gonna be 23. Yep. Not bad. Okay, good, that works. Now we can focus on the rest. So next is the slick just here. Now for these ones, we can make a new sprite. Which is here. Now we have that. So of course we focus on making the sprite fit the shape here. So first we scale it down and we see it has to be a bit bigger. And it will be exactly the same as the diagram, but that's okay. This is still just for learning purposes. No, that's too big. I guess that could be good enough. Maybe on the edge could be a bit shorter. Like this. Yeah, that's better. Now this we can work with. Okay, so next we rework this collision shape. Actually, we should make a new one. It doesn't fit completely in between, so might as well give it some leeway. Okay, that's good enough. Okay, we have that. Now the area to check the activation. I think it can be just a rectangle. Even on that, there's always more space here. This is always gonna be a problem. Hopefully you can measure the angle of this. Seems to be 68 degrees. So this is fine. Then I guess just that is enough. I have to accept that at least here on the top it should be okay to detect the ball, so we can, I guess we have to live with this. Okay, so there's that. To work on the bounce component. Which, how the hell do I make this again? Well, at least here the diagram gives us some information, so we can use this as a reference. In that case, we will have to edit them here. So I move this one, this here. So now its rest angle is 16.8. Okay, that's good. But now the peak angle should be higher. They should be 56. Right now we do the same with the other one. Which has a rest angle of 63. Okay, so it's also stage. That's good. Its peak it's gonna be 73. I guess not anymore. It's gonna be 82. I guess this will have to do for collision's sake. Okay, 268. Okay. Let's push this back. And now we duplicate this one. And move it here to the other side. It's not really sitting on the opposite side. But I guess that's good enough. Now we need to inverse all of the areas. Never mind, not that. Was it 45? I always forget. I guess that will do. We can work with this. Okay, that area is done. Like this one. I need to redo the bounce components. This is gonna be the problem. How do I move this to the other point? Oh, it was not easy. Now here it's 112. And I guess it's gonna be 124. This one is also 112. Okay, now this one will be, was it 98? Yeah. That was not a work. Okay, let's see if it pays off. I think I forgot something else. Ah, yeah, it was this. The shape's not matching. So if I remember correctly, all we have to do is invert the gate's position. Just like that. Right, now it should work as intended. Now I still need to make an effect for the slingshot when it gets activated. Something felt odd there. I think I do want to see the bounce. Oh, never mind, I think it's actually working as I wanted to. Okay, that's it. We can leave it at that. Okay, there's the slingshots, we have those. Now what else do we need to work on? There's right, the bumpers. So let's replace the sprite. Let's see where is it. This one's too big. So first let's make it a bit more transparent. So we can... Well, we still cannot see behind the keyboard. It still covers the whole thing. It's weird how it's not updating. No, it's not because of that. Then why? Right, I have no idea why it's not updating the changes. Ah, perfect. Whatever, I guess I could have to edit it here. Actually, it seems like that's the perfect size. Yeah, pretty much. This is fine, then when I detected the collision, it expands. It expands it good. So I guess I leave it like this. Do we need another one here? And it's still changing them to... Ah, wait, I think I know why. It's because of this. I shouldn't have to delete them before. Yep, but the company mission is too big. That should not happen. Maybe I do have to move this a bit to the left, the right. There we go, now it's an actual pinball. Okay, we've got another component out. The next one should be the spinner here. Yeah, I think that's perfect enough. Never mind. Actually, maybe we should just remove one bumper. Maybe a bit to the left. But actually, both of these should be a bit lower. Like this, and this one to the right. That should give us plenty more space to walk around. Never mind. So this is still not enough. Okay, now it seems we work. Okay, well, that's fit. Now for this one's in particular, yeah, maybe like this. And I like it to spin more often. But how do I do that? Maybe like this. I guess we leave it like that. Okay, we have the slingshots, spinner, the bumpers. I think the one component left is the triggers here. So just like it is here, we bring the visual component here and the trigger down here. Now, how did I name it? Right, first we have the monitor, and inside here we make the rollovers. Actually, the ball should go behind the spinner. I wonder if I can give it a higher ordering. Hopefully that works. Okay, back to this. Right, so we need to make this a bit bigger. And actually we can replace this with the new sprite. I think that it is too small. Perfect size, okay. And yeah, let's leave it there. Now the area, maybe down here. Okay, now we'll copy these two components and push it around here. Okay, and that should be all we need. How do I trigger all the... It will always be complicated. because they will need to pass through these areas right here in the middle. But I guess if we can get at least one working, we know for sure that the others, yeah. I just assume that it's working. But maybe some visual indicator that they have to hit this area here will be useful. Or maybe we can add that later. Yeah, that should be fine. Okay, there's still the triggers that we didn't add, but it's getting a bit late, so I will leave that to another day. However, I think we can still add one small treat, because to make it really feel like it's a pinball, we need some sound. And for that, I found some other assets for that. So let's see if this sounds good. This one is definitely for the bumpers. This one probably for the slingshot. Actually this one. These two for the target. This is for when it gets released, and for charging. This one. And most importantly for the flippers. Did it crash? I think I'm still alive. That's weird. Should to show an error message. I guess as long as I don't close it, it will stay open. Okay, so maybe we should make this quick. Okay, so for the assets, okay, I think that should be all. That's weird, I think it's the music player that caused the error. That's weird. Well, anyway, now we can add these sounds here. So we have the flipper, the bumper. The rover and the slingshot. One, two, three, four. One, two, three. All right, the punch. Let's try first this one. Okay, perfect. That one's done. Now the slingshot. Luckily, we don't need to save the variable for the audio. All we need to do is cut the reference and make it play. it's hard to make them keep the slingshots. Yeah, there we go. It's not perfect, but it will do. Okay, now another for the bumper. Okay, that one works. Now the flipper. Okay, for this one, it also needs to be references. Oh, still doing that. Alright, because I forgot to remove that. Sorry. I can't see really like that effect now that I hear it. We'll try finding another one. And this one's much better. Now I'm starting to sound like an actual pinball. the last one is the rollover. And for this one, it's also a reference to the audio player. And we also need the constants. Now, where do I set this? Now here. And we need to actually trigger the areas. Really, not even once. There we go. Okay, we can confirm that they are working. Okay, I think we can make some good progress this time. Why did I add something for the rollover? No, I guess I can add that later. But yeah, we did some good progress this time. We made an actual working table with the components, and we add some sounds. And it feels like an actual pinball table. So I guess we can stop there for today. Now here on the dashboard it says that I'm still alive, so I'll believe that. Now let's see if we can raid somebody. And yes, it seems we can. So thank you everyone who stopped by. Have a nice rest of your week. And who shall trade? Yeah, whatever, let's go here. Good everyone, till next time.